Don't be angry with him, Father.
Oh, my children that I love so well, what wrong you do to me?
We're still your children. You can go on loving us.
Why could you not resist the spell of one seductive tree?
We still love you.
When all around you, I gave you fields to roam, sapphire skies and chromium waterfalls. All that I had to give, I gave to you.
But Father, didn't you think we would ever grow up?
Ungrateful children live in the wilderness.
Why did you put questions in me?
Why did you disobey me?
That's not an answer.
Bear your own children. Answer for yourselves.
We will.
Sweat to make your daily bread, while thorns and thistle muck your harvest. Sweat to the day you return to the clay, for which it seems you yearn.
We'll manage on our own.
Dust you were, dust you are, to dust you will return. And at this place I set my sword, forever will it burn!
Be replaced. Let's see.
Come to supper.
Papa?
Yes?
Will Father ever answer us?
Of course he will.
When?
Cain, Father put us here as punishment.
I know that.
If we are good and careful and show him how much we love him, one day he will bring us back home.
I thought this was our home.
This is our home.
Papa?
Yes?
What's above the waterfall?
What do you mean?
What's above the waterfall?
Water is what's above the waterfall. Eat your supper.
And what about the mountains over there?
You don't need to know that.
Why not?
Cain, I don't think you should ask so many questions.
Papa, why won't you let us go beyond the waterfall?
Cain!
Let me ask you a question, Cain. What if you, or I, or any of us, wandered over the waterfall or past the mountains, and while we are gone, Father came to take us back to Eden? What then?
I don't know.
We would miss our chance, wouldn't we? Is that what you want?
No.
Good. If you love me, if you love this family, you will never go beyond the waterfall. Either of you.
We promise, Papa. Cain?
We promise.
I feel a coldness in the pit of my stomach. I feel a watchfulness in back of my eyes. I carry a load of heavy foreboding I cannot explain. My boys are healthy, they grow bigger and stronger. No sign of trouble, but I recognize the heat and the hunger of when I was younger. I see it now in Cain. I used to think it was the spark of creation. But was it just a defect in me, a flaw in my nature? And now look what I've done. I've passed it to my son, this wild inclination. Is it the spark of creation?
Abel, come on. Mama and Papa are down by the river. I packed the provisions. We could be miles away by nightfall.
I'm not coming.
Oh, Father, these gifts may you receive to thank you.
Abel, come with me. We can't stay rotting away here forever.
Here we are, your grateful children. Please accept our sacrifice.
All these years of this cruel joke, the best of our harvest growing up in smoke, praying for a future from these silent stony shelves. How much more of this must we take? This is the morning we finally make a future for ourselves.
Okay, if it's God's will that we were put here.
Is it God's will, or have we all been conned? Brother, we will never know, we will never grow, if we never go beyond.
But we promised, Cain.
Well, we wouldn't be the first to break a promise.
I never made this world, I didn't even choose it, and I know no one said it was fair. But they had a garden once, they had a chance to choose it, they gave it away, including my share. And now we're lost in the wilderness, lost crying in the wilderness. And if anyone's watching, it seems he couldn't care less. We're lost in the wilderness.
I can't believe that, Cain.
Why can't you?
Maybe I'm just not as angry as you are.
Well, you should be.
You follow all the rules. You swallow all the stories, and every night you wish on a star. Dreaming your day will come, trusting in allegories. And every morning, boy, look where you are. Lost in the wilderness, lost, slowly dying in the wilderness. With no chance of living, boy, until you confess you're lost in the wilderness. Don't you ever watch the eagle fly to the sun and wonder how he got to be so free? If you ever have, you know your journey's begun. Hey, what have we got to lose, boy, when already we are lost in the wilderness? And where we are headed, boy, I couldn't even guess. But off we go without a warning, running as we hit the ground. Where our future lies are burning, where our hearts are outward bound. Till one bright and one distant morning, we may stop and look around. And there in the wilderness, finally we'll be found.
Cain?
Who's there?
Abel?
Who is it, Cain?
It must be... Father?
He's not as big as I thought.
Cain, Abel, let me look at you. What fine young men you've become. How old are you, Cain?
17, Father.
Grandfather. And Abel, why, you're taller than your brother now.
Yes, Grandfather.
I didn't think you'd ever come.
Well, here I am.
You've come to take us back to Eden.
I've come to see my grandchildren. You do have your mother's eyes. And whose offering is this?
Mine, Grandfather.
Come here, Abel. Thank you. You're a good boy. And what about you, Cain? Where is your offering?
I'll go get Mama and Papa.
No, I won't be seeing them.
Why?
I didn't come to see your parents.
But they're waiting for you. They've been waiting for years. Papa calls you every night.
You are my children now. In you I place my hope.
But Papa said you'd forgive us and bring us all back to the garden.
We're not going back to the garden, Abel.
What?
There is no garden. Not for us, is there?
What a fine home you have here. What work your parents have done. Look at this. I'll bet your father made this.
He did.
You should be proud of him.
We are.
Honor your father and mother, Cain. Do as they tell you and keep up your offerings.
What for?
Come here, Cain. Cain, I will come again soon, and when I do, I will have a gift for you. For both of you, actually. I will bring you both wives.
Wives? Of our own? Cain!
Why can't we choose wives for ourselves?
Cain?
Because I will choose the perfect wife for you. And then you can start your families and give me my first great-grandchildren.
Why should we give you anything?
You must have faith in me, Cain.
Like my father has faith in you. And why did you come now anyways? To stop us from leaving?
I came to keep you safe.
I don't need you to keep me safe. Did you really think I'd be here chanting a prayer? Till you finally deigned to reappear? Nothing you could say could stop me heading out there, when all I know about you is you left us here. Lost, abandoned in the wilderness. So you can keep your bribes and temptations. I'm gonna find my own destination, out in the wasteland with nothing to guide me but this burning inside me.
Cain, don't go.
The spark of creation.
Cain!
He'll be back.
Will he?
He has to come back.
Abel, say nothing of this to your parents. I was never here. You don't know why Cain ran away. This must be our secret. Do you understand?
Yes, Grandfather.
Promise.
Promise.
You're a good boy.
Abel, my grandson, you are the future. All my hopes live in you. Don't break my heart.
Cain! 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 He'll be all right, Papa. And what if Father finally comes for us while he's gone? What then, Abel? What then?
I don't know.
Damn him anyway.
All that I had to give, I gave that boy. Once he was young and once he brought my heart such joy. He'd ride my shoulders and cross the fields we'd roam. I still can see those moments like yesterday. I was a fool to think they'd make him want to stay at home.
1, 2, 3, owls are in the tree. 4, 5, 6, foxes in the sticks. 6, 5, 4, goslings on the shore. 3, 2, 1, now we all go home.
We tried to make a home.
1, 2, 3, owls are in the tree.
Heaven knows the lifespan
far. 5, 6, foxes in the sticks.
Summer's brief and arid.
6, 5, 4, goslings on the shore.
Winter's bleak and numb.
3, 2, 1, now we all go home.
Look what we call home. These old walls are stained and scarred.
I can still remember what each scar was from.
You could call it rundown,
worn out,
threadbare, and I guess you'd come close to home, close to home. And I remember in someone else's garden long ago, we had all we could eat.
But it seems the fruit our own hands grow somehow tastes twice as sweet.
6, 5, 4, goslings on the shore. 3, 2, 1, now we all go home.
On this barren plot.
1, 2, 3, owls are in the tree.
We'll plant our wheat and dig our wells.
4, 5, 6, foxes in the sticks.
And we'll be a family.
6, 5, 4, goslings on the shore.
Steady as a star.
Look at what we've got.
Ba-ba-bum, ba-ba-ba-ba-bum.
Only what we've made ourselves.
8, 9, 10, now we start again.
Though it's next to nothing, look how rich we are.
Funny now how Eden doesn't seem so far.
Come sit beside me in the dying light. What storms the morning brings will weather all right. Your hand in my hand, and as we sit here huddled in the gloam, paradise seems strangely close, close to home, close to home.
3, 2, 1, now we all go home.
Abel, Mama, Papa!
Cain? Cain! Cain! Where have you been?
Past the waterfall, Mama. Past the waterfall and beyond.
come, Abel, quick, Abel, wait till I show you what I found.
Cain, before you say another word.
No, Papa, now, Papa, it's a thing that will astound you. When I show you what I found, you won't believe.
Eve!
Come on!
Look,
what are they?
Stones. A giant ring of stones.
But how did they get here?
People! People must have put them here!
Yes, people. Other people.
What? How can there be other people?
All of my life I think it's this I've been seeking. Pent up inside me like an underground spring. Find me a future, find me an answer. Written in a ring of stones, finally proof of what I've always known. We are not alone. Damned we may be, but we are not alone.
All of a sudden I can feel the old tingling, the urge to question, the itch to explore. I feel it once more.
Stones the size of giants in a perfect circle.
What could be their purpose? What could be their meaning?
In a perfect circle.
How could they have raised them?
Must have taken 100 stones the size of giants.
How long have they been here? Could we find the people?
Think about their knowledge. Think about their science.
Think about their strength and skill. Scary they may be, but still, I will never rest until
we have found these strange, bewildering people who would build a ring of giant stones.
All of my life I think it's this I've been seeking. We are not alone.
The rain will be here soon. We'd best get back to the shelter of our glen.
But what about these people?
We will never speak of them again.
Adam?
Papa, listen. For once, just listen.
Tear it all down. That's what you want. Tear down everything we've worked to build. Trust our lives to a bunch of ragged strangers. You see the promise, Cain, but not the dangers. You think they're so wise, you think they're so skilled, but you've never heard them chanting in the ring of stones. Never seen them dancing here among the bones of the beasts they've killed.
Now, how do you know what they are?
Because I've been here. I've seen them.
Adam!
Is this why we couldn't go beyond the waterfall?
When were you here?
The two of you were babies still, a long, long time ago.
You never told me.
It was better not to know. It would still be better not to know.
All these years you've lied
all
to
years
us.
You never told. Never
all these years they lied to us a future.
All these years, couldn't you
it's
trust
right
me?
Don't it's even know who the father is.
Couldn't you
would
trust
our
me?
Father be betrayed? What if these are people he never
everybody
made?
Stop fighting.
After all these years, to
after all these years,
might
all I see is you are still afraid. There was a time once you were so brave, Adam.
And look what we got. Look where it brought us. Look at the lesson our bravery taught us. We are lost in the wilderness. We belong out here in the wilderness.
Well then, stay here forever if that's how you want to live. but Abel and I could find comrades and wives and learn what it means to have hope in our lives. Be part of a tribe, part of a clan, not just one family, but a family of men. Come on, Abel.
Abel, if you go now, you will never see me again.
That's all right, because we're never coming back. Abel.
Abel.
Oh, Cain, please don't make me choose. Either way, it's more than I can bear to lose. Either way, it's ripping out my heart. This choice is tearing me apart.
Abel, Father will come for us, and you'll be left behind.
Father's not coming back. Not for you, not for any of us.
That's not true, Abel.
Tell him, brother. Cain, Papa came for us when you were down by the river. He came to spy on his grandchildren. He didn't want to see you.
Abel, is this true?
No.
Liar!
Are you coming or not?
No.
Fine. I'll be better off without you. Get out of my way.
You're not going anywhere.
Is this what it means to be a father? Crushing the spirits of your children like an egg. Is that what it means to be a father? Binding them to you with a chain around the legs.
Adam!
Get out of my way, old man.
Just let him go.
Never!
I'll kill you!
Cain!
Let me go!
Stop it!
Stop it, Cain, both of you!
Let me go! Let me go! That should have been you. That should have been you.
In the wasteland, Abel, my child, you must not die. You must not die. You must not die. You must not die. You must not. You must not.
From the ground. I curse that ground and I curse you. Be a fugitive and a vagabond all your wretched life. And should you find a wife, I curse her too. And all your tainted progeny, your children's children's children, even to the seventh generation. Let the righteous hear the seed of Cain. With guilt and shame is ridden. All concourse with them is forevermore forbidden. Shun them like the scorpion and shark. And that you may know them, on Cain I set this mark. The race of Cain must ever bear this mark.
Thank you.
Father. Father, speak to me once more. Just once. Tell me what happened to Cain, Father. It's all I want to know. It's all Adam ever wanted to know. I know you can hear me. I know it. After Abel was killed, I knew that Cain was gone for good. But Adam, he would never believe it. Every day, I'd see him standing in the fields, searching the hills for a sign of Cain coming home. He never came. I don't even know today whether he's alive or dead. And you're not going to tell me, are you? No. We had our second chance with Seth. A wonderful boy, just like Adam, naming and numbering everything in sight. At 17, he upped and disappeared without a word. Scared us both to death. But he came back 2 weeks later with a girl from some tribe over the mountains. They had 7 children in as many years. 2 sets of twins. Oh, I don't know how she manages. And then one winter, Adam died. Suddenly, no warning. He just fell over in the fields and didn't get up. We buried him by the waterfall. Was that the right thing to do, Father? Three of Seth's children are married already, and I now have my first great-grandchild, Zora. I wish Adam could have seen her. We farm the whole valley now, and half the range of mountains to the south.